Myself, Milan Patel, Assistant Professor at LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. Today's topic is about angular measurement. In this lecture, we will cover first various terms related to angular measurement and measurement of bearings, means angles. Let's start with various terms related to angular measurements. Basically, there are four main terms. First is meridian. Bearing of a line always measure clockwise with respect to some reference direction. This fixed reference direction is known as meridian. We will understand it by figure. Suppose there is the earth, there is the north pole, there is one line. If we measure the angle or bearing of the line with respect to north pole, this fixed north pole direction or this reference direction is called as meridian. The horizontal angle made by survey line with the magnetic north or fixed reference meridian is called as bearing of the line. This is called as bearing of the line. The angle made by line with respect to the meridian line is called as bearing of that line. Now, let's see various types of meridian. There are three types of meridian. First is true meridian, second is magnetic meridian, and third is arbitrary meridian. We will understand it by figure. Suppose there is the earth, there is the true north, there is the magnetic north, which is achieved by the magnetic compass. The direction shown by the magnetic compass is called as magnetic north direction. Suppose there is a line AB. The true meridian line is the fixed reference line which connects true north and true south point. If we made an angle from true meridian line to the our survey line, this horizontal angle is called as true bearing of the line. If we connect magnetic north and magnetic south, or the direction shown by freely suspended magnetic needle of the compass is called as magnetic meridian. The horizontal angle made by the survey line with respect to magnetic meridian line is called as magnetic bearing of the line. Next is arbitrary meridian. This arbitrary meridian is the one type of assumed direction which is used when true meridian and magnetic meridian is not available. Like if you are working on plot or land, from above one electric line is passing. This electric line creates magnetic field which affects the magnetic direction of the compass. At that place, magnetic compass cannot be used and we cannot use magnetic meridian as our reference direction. And if we are working on closed environment, like in closed room or closed hall, we have to assume one reference direction as our meridian, which is called as arbitrary meridian. If the horizontal angle made by the line with respect to arbitrary meridian, it is called as arbitrary bearing. That's all about types of meridian. Now let's discuss the declination. You have heard about this term before. So what is declination? Suppose there is the true north or true meridian line. This is the magnetic north, magnetic meridian line. The horizontal angle made between magnetic meridian and true meridian is called as declination. This is the definition of declination. The horizontal angle between true north and magnetic north at a place at the time of observation is called as magnetic declination. Or the horizontal angle between magnetic meridian and true meridian is known as magnetic declination. This declination is of two types. First is declination west. Suppose there is a true meridian, this is the magnetic meridian. Suppose there is a one line AB, this is called as true meridian. The horizontal angle made by the line with true meridian is called as true bearing. The horizontal angle made by the line with respect to magnetic meridian is called as magnetic bearing. The difference between true bearing and magnetic bearing is called as declination. If the declination lies towards the west direction, it is called as declination west. This is the definition of declination west. when north end of the magnetic needle is pointed towards which side of the true meridian? The position is called as declination west. For declination towards west, true bearing is equal to magnetic bearing minus declination west. Next type of declination is declination east. This is the true meridian. This is the magnetic meridian. This is the one line AB. This is the true bearing. This is the magnetic bearing. This is called as declination east. If magnetic north direction lies towards the east direction from the true meridian line, it is called as declination east. Let's see its definition. When the north end of the magnetic needle is pointed towards east side of the true meridian, the position is called as declination east. It is also called as theta E. For declination towards east, true bearing is equal to magnetic bearing plus declination east. This is all about declination. Now let's see the dip of magnetic needle. So what is dip of a magnetic needle? We will understand it by one figure. Suppose this is a magnetic needle and this is a horizontal plane. You all know the magnetic needle is deflected towards the earth. Because of this deflection, one angle is formed from the horizontal plane. The magnetic needle dips on one of its side towards the pole due to magnetic influence of the earth. The angle made by deflected needle with the horizontal plane is known as dip of a magnetic needle. Now let's see various types of lines which are used in angular measurements. First is isogonic line. A line which passes through the points of equal declination is known as isogonic line. Second is agonic line. A line which passes through the points of zero declination, it is called as agonic line. And isoclinic line, a line which passes through the points of equal tip points is known as isoclinic lines. That's all about various terms related to angular measurement. Now we will see our second topic of today's lecture, which is measurement of bearing. So what is bearing? Bearing is the horizontal angle between meridian and the line. It is measured by three methods. First is whole circle bearing method or WCB method. Second is quadrantal bearing method or QB method. And third is reduced bearing method or RB method. First we will see whole circle bearing method, WCB method. So what is WCB? We will understand it by figure. The horizontal angle in WCB type of method is with respect to magnetic north only. Here you can see all the lines are made angle from the magnetic north in clockwise direction. So all angles are made in clockwise direction from magnetic north only. This is called as WCB type of bearings or whole circle bearing. The value varies from 0 degree to 360 degree. Here first line you can say 66 degree. The angle made from magnetic north in clockwise direction towards the line. Here you can see 165 degree line. The angle starts from the magnetic north in clockwise direction, north towards the south in anticlockwise direction. Because in whole circle bearing we have to go from magnetic north in clockwise direction for whole circle. Okay, this is called as WCB method or whole circle bearing. Second type of bearing is quadrantal bearing or QB, you can say. Here in QB, horizontal angle is measured with respect to magnetic north or magnetic south, whichever is nearest to the survey line. You can clearly see, suppose N 66 degree E or north 66 degree east line, you can see. For that line, north pole is nearer, so angle is made from north pole towards the line. Suppose you can say south 15 degree east line. Here north pole is far away from that line, south pole is nearer, so angle is made from south pole in anticlockwise. In quadrantal bearing you can go for clockwise as well as anticlockwise, but you have to remember one thing: the angle should be nearer to magnetic north or magnetic south, whichever is nearest. Okay, the values varies from 0 to 90 only. The value of QV cannot be more than 90 degree. That's all about quadrangle bearing. Now we will understand the difference between WCD system and QV system. This is the difference. First difference, in WCB, the horizontal angle made by the line with magnetic north in clockwise direction is called as whole circle bearing of that line. Okay, quadrangle bearing system, the horizontal angle made by the line with magnetic north or magnetic south, whichever is nearest to the line in eastward or westward direction, is called as quadrangle bearing or reduced bearing of that line. WCB system, magnetic north line is considered as a reference line, while in QB system both magnetic north as well as magnetic south can be used as our reference line. In WCB system, only clockwise angle from the reference line is taken, while in QB system both clockwise as well as anti-clockwise angles are taken. In WCB system, the value of bearings is between 0 degree to 360 degree, while in QB system, the value of bearings is between 0 degree to 90 degree. Whole circle bearing is measured by prismatic compass, while quadrangle bearing is measured by surveyor's compass. These are the five differences between WCB system and QB system. Now, let's discuss the last type of bearing, which is reduced type of bearing. The name itself suggests it is a reduced bearing. Okay? So, what is reduced bearing? When the whole circle bearing of the line is converted into the quadrant bearing, it is termed as reduced bearing because the value of WCB is higher compared to the quadrant bearing. If we converted the value from WCB into the QB, the value reduced. So it is called as reduced bearing. It is similar to quadrant bearing. Its value lies between 0 degree to 90 degree. But here the quadrant should be mentioned for proper designation. Okay, we convert WCB into RB by referring this table. If WCB of line is between 0 degree to 90 degree, means the line lies in the first quadrant, the rule for conversion from WCB into RB is equal to RB is equal to WCB. The value remains same for first quadrant. Okay, for second quadrant or the value between 90 degree to 180 degree, the RB can be found out by 180 degree minus WCB. Okay, the quadrant is southeast quadrant. Third, if the value of WCB is between 180 degree to 270 degree, the value of RB can be found out by WCB minus 180 degree. The line lies on southwest direction. And the fourth, if WCB of the line is between 270 degree to 360 degree, RB can be found out by 360 degree minus WCB, and the line lies on the fourth quadrant, which is northwest quadrant. Okay, this table can be used for converting WCB into the RB. Okay, we have some examples of conversion from WCB into RB. First example, suppose the WCB is equal to 55 degree. So what will be the RB? Okay, we will calculate by using this table. Suppose this is a direction, north-south direction, east-west direction. 55 degree is shown by this. Okay, north is 0 degree, east is 90 degree, south is 180 degree, west is 270 degree, and north is against 360 degree. So here 55 degree is shown like this. Line falls in first quadrant. So RB is equal to WCB. So RB can be written as north 55 degree east. Always remember north and south comes first, after east and west, because quadrant bearing or RB is found out by taking angles from magnetic north or magnetic south, whichever is nearest. So always north and south comes first, east and west last. Okay, so RB is north 55 degree east. We will take another example. Suppose WCB is equal to 135 degree. We will draw it. North is 0 degree, east 90, south 180 degree, west 270, and again north 360 degree. So 135 lies on the second quadrant like this. okay, time falls in second quadrant. So RB is equal to 180 degree minus WCB, 180 degree minus 135 degree, like this. This is 45 degree. So RB can be written as south 45 degree towards east. Now let's see another example. Suppose WCB is equal to 240 degree. 240 means it lies in the third quadrant, like this. Okay. RB is equal to WCB minus 180 degree. Okay. RB can be written as like this, which is 60 degree. So it is written as south 60 degree towards west, because angle starts from south towards the west side. So it is written as south 60 degree west. And the last example, suppose WCB is equal to 335 degree, which is drawn as like this, 335 degree. Okay, line falls in the fourth quadrant. So it is found out, RB can be found out by 360 degree minus WCB, like this. It is 25 degree. So angle start from north direction towards the west side. So it is written as north 25 degree west. So this is how we can convert WCB into the RB. Okay, this is all about measurement of bearings. I hope you understand these two topics, terms related to angular measurement and measurement of bearing. See you soon in the next lecture.